Adjustments are made throughout because there are always adjustments in this game.
I want to see if they come out conservative, trying to minimize errors, or if they have enough confidence to attack early and try to take advantage of the other team's nervousness.
Talk all the hype, but the past is prologue as this Super Bowl is underway. That's fielded in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Here come the Bengals now to take over. They'll be led out by the Red Rifle from TCU. It's buried at the 45-yard line.
Okay, he all kind of like missed it. Okay.
They talked about their script, didn't they? 10 to 15 plays, the first 10 to 15 they had on their script. Nowhere on the script was there throwing an interception, I have to believe.
Okay, we got the perfect camera angle. Hi. Alrighty.
Here's Newton. Deep drop. Oh, he he's going to take a shot right away. So they took a shot on first down, but couldn't connect. Well, they went for all the marbles there on that long pass. He caught it, just couldn't stay in bounds.
So difficult, man.
No, I'm not going to.
Isn't it? Because you have so many things you're going through on that play, trying to get open, trying to catch the ball, and still get your feet down to complete the process of the play. Not successful on that attempt.
Sliding out of the pocket. Now he's going to throw it deep to the other side of the field. And there he comes. Panthers touchdown. It's Benjamin on the ground. Kelvin Benjamin, 44 yards. And the Panthers are going to take a first quarter lead. So he scrambled right, but was able to look back toward the middle of the end zone to find a target.
As you know, in this game, sometimes you just have to know when to break the rules, because we all know most guys throwing the football are taught never throw back into the middle of the field on a scramble. He did it and got away with it for a touchdown.
Instinct sometimes, right? They just take over.
Dude. Instinct and vision sometimes just seem to... They're really just mistakes quite open, right? Dude.
Touchdown here to kick it away. Now we take it in the end zone. And the decision to bring it out is going to cost him about 7 yards all told, as he's taken down back shy of the 20. There, the O-line, everybody really on offense. They were just manhandled at the point of attack.
They could pretty much call them all out. Could he almost my name, right? That was a very tough sequence for the offensive line. But how about that defensive front? Creating a new line of scrimmage and creating a long yardage possibility.
And lose a yard that time, and that's going to lead to a third down.
Back-to-back runs that were stacked up. Offensively, now you got to think to yourself, do we change blocking assignments? Do we change formations? Do we change looks in order to try and get the running game going?
No gain on the play there. Nice job defensively. And it likely forces a punt situation on fourth.
I know in most cases people think you throw the ball in this situation, and when they ran, it almost felt like a little bit of a surrender, maybe a give up. But I don't know if that's really the case. They might have been probing a little bit, checking the defense and filing it away for later. They might have something worth it.
Good blocking there. Nearly sprung him as it is. It'll go as a 19-yard return. And the Panthers will get it here as they take possession. Now, former Iowa Hawkeye, it's Braylon Wager.
Concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh! There he goes.
Here's Newton. And they don't get it.
Oh.
They tried for the 2-point conversion there, but unsuccessful. Protection was great. He had time to set up a campsite. But in the secondary, though, they were ready.
And I think that in most places on the field, if you have that much time to throw the ball, someone's going to shake free and you'll find an open receiver. But condensed, near the goal line, on a 2-point conversion, all that exit, you know, there's not any extra field. So it kind of closes in on them, and that allows you to cover a little bit better.
Cincinnati now ready to take the field. And on the first drive, 3 and out. And I know that these are professional athletes, but I would imagine sometimes you get the nerves at the beginning. Let's go, and down he goes. Yeah. on second down. Looking for Green, and it's intercepted. But Green, and it's picked off. And they're going to set up shop at the 27-yard line.
And Brandon, this is a real nice job defensively, getting inside the quarterback's head and figuring out, okay, where is he going with the football? Because you can make an educated guess defensively, not all the time, but sometimes. And when you're right, you've got a decent chance of coming away with the football.
Here come the Panthers now, set to take over on offense. And they hit the home run last drive. One play on the ground all the way to the house. Now the defense, maybe they're expecting a run here.
Carter, I love your description, because when we talk about hitting the home run, we're usually thinking about a passing play, aren't we? Something in the air, deep ball.
Gosh, guys. Y'all are being, like, stupid. You can't see the score that way, but every now and then I'll just do that, okay?
Just taking it big-time jaunt. Now if you're coming back out, now they've established his run game, the play-action pass could very well be open.
Escaping the pressure right. They showed off a nice juke of the defender before the next wave could bring it down.
And that was not a bad scramble there on first down. He didn't force it, nor did he throw it away. He was able to take off, and now he made it a very manageable second and short.
They'll come out in the pistol. To throw on second down and two. In the green field position as of yet. Here's third and nine. The play clock's running down. Throwing on third down. Newton finishes with a catch over the middle. They get seven there, but it brings up forward.
So much about offense is what we call hidden yardage. You know, you throw the ball to someone, they catch it, and then they can make a big play. You know, they create a play, run after catch. They did a really nice job here limiting that and keeping them from a first down.
And stopped them in his tracks. So he splits the uprights there, and I would imagine it's nice as a kicker. Right when it leaves your foot, you know it's good.
Yeah, it's kind of like a golfer that picks up his tee after a nice drive without even watching it land.
Solid analogy. I like it. This is taken about 7 yards deep. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. Now this Bengals offensive unit, ready to see what they can do here. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
And he'll toss this one incomplete. Seeing no options, he throws it away. They come up with exactly 1 minute to go in this first quarter. Second and 10. Backing up. This one grabbed by A.J. Green. That one goes for 13 yards and moves and sticks. So we have now seen connection number one between Dalton and Adriel Jeremiah, A.J. Green.
Say that again.
Adriel Jeremiah.
Look at you. You are full of knowledge and information. And you know something? I bet Andy Dalton learned his full name as well, because he figured out quickly, this is going to be my number one target. I got to know this guy in a big way.
It's a pickup of four, and it'll bring up second down.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still, a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Alongside Charles Davis, Brandon Gaudin, and it's the Bengals with the football to begin quarter number two. They've got it second and six to start things out. Second down, Dalton. And that's incomplete. Giovanni Bernard, the intended receiver, out of the backfield. And it's third down. Third down here for the offense after the incomplete pass.
Whether you deserve credit or not, the defense is going to take credit for that incompletion, because it always feels good when you slow down an offense.
Now Dalton brought in here by Tyler Eifert. Give him 6 yards and they do convert on third.
Obviously, this has not been a banner game throwing the football. So what you gotta do, you gotta kind of down focus, don't you think? Find the tight end, take some easier completions.
That interception last time, there he hits the reliable target. And he's gonna be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
When you put together a formula for winning defense, it's exactly what we're seeing in this game. Controlling the line of scrimmage, attacking, and changing everything so that now they're putting the offense's backfield. They're playing an excellent game.
Throwing over the middle, but it's incomplete. He was looking for his favorite target, A.J. Green, that time. Third down here. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second down incompletion. Fakes the give to Bernard. Dalton. He's going to loft one deep left side here. And a shot taken on third down, unsuccessful. Fourth down now.
I know I'm not giving up credit to the defense because that pass was incomplete. But come on, it was A.J. Green. I always expect him to come up with the ball.
Yeah, on those deep routes especially, even on incompletions, it's fun to watch him run those routes.
It certainly is, but he eats up ground and he usually goes up and gets it.
And no return possible here as they angle this one out of bounds. Carolina getting set to take the field. And they split the uprights last time for three. They've got the lead. They're not going to play this conservative. They're not hoping for another field goal. They're hoping for a touchdown.
I'm with you on that one. I like where your head is. I like the way you're thinking because you're exactly right. Trying to sit on a lead and play that way, that doesn't work too well for most teams. Run your offense. Run what you do best. Exactly.
Well, this is taken in. It's complete. Touchdown, Carolina! Down to 72 yards! And the Panthers add on to their lead. Well, you know, he can be explosive, and he's ultra-explosive there on the fly route.
And you know how many times we've talked to coaches, and we've had quoted back to us, well, you know something? When you execute really well, it doesn't matter if they know it's coming or not. But sometimes athleticism beats you as well. He just took off and went. Hey, that's almost like one of your turkey bowl games, isn't it? Just go warm, man.
Yard.
I'll hit you. And it worked really well for them.
Gano for the extra point. Oh, it's blocked.
Dude.
Oh, the Bengals have got it. But he doesn't get far. They're able to stop him. And after all that, the extra point attempt unsuccessful.
I remember when they changed the rule, and there's a lot of consternation. Especially coming from the kickers. Okay, how's this going to affect things, having to kick a longer one now? Much more of a field goal attempt. And the defensive guys saw it as an opportunity to get more block.
That's exactly right. There's more effort now. Before, when it was snapped down near the goal line, you would basically see guys just stand there.
Yeah, not anymore. Now, those guys are going after it because not only can they knock it away and change a little bit of momentum,
and get 2 points.
They can pick it up and take it back for 2 points.
Now a play fake here on first down. And seeing no options, he just tosses this one away incomplete. Now that'll bring up second down.
It's a tried and true formula, and I don't think it'll change for as long as we play football. If someone's trying to throw the ball, and you can put pressure on them and make it tough, that's only going to help you defense.
Yeah, he's since being hurried. He got rid of it before taking the hit with incomplete. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage back at the 22.
With the struggles we're seeing up front for the offense today, they've got to think about changing up their play call. Some screens, some draws, some quick hitting plays in order to try and supplement the run game. You don't totally abandon it.
Under heavy pressure and down goes Dalton on the sack. Luke Kuechly, he's the one that gets him down. It'll be a loss of five, and it'll bring up fourth down.
Well, certainly some teams are not intimidated by down and distance on defense, are they? Third and very long? Let's go get this guy again. Big-time pressure.
And he's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. That's pulled in at the 32. Look at the spin. Balance. Nice job bringing that one back. 14 on the return. And the offense will come back onto the field for the first and 10. Cam Newton getting ready to go again on offense. And he's been good. 2 first-half touchdown passes, no interceptions so far.
Does a lot for your confidence, does a great deal for your team, gives them a lead, and they feel really good about how they're playing. I think he expects to throw at least another one.
I was going to say, now he wants the first half hat trick, doesn't he?
Oh, without a doubt. Go ahead and fling him on the field, folks. He wants that type of celebration.
Now Newton. Comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. They were looking to get it to Kelvin Benjamin there. And it's third down.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
And he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. He's going to air one out. This is caught inside the 15. And he takes this down deep into Cincinnati territory. They were ready for what the defense was showing. They had prepared for that look, recognized it, went straight to the air, got the first. Well done.
Love the recognition, because you can prepare for everything. You can watch the tape and put together your game plan, but you still have to understand what they're doing in terms of what they're showing and be able to adjust accordingly, and they did exactly that.
They go play action here on first down. Oh, look at the juke. And the Panthers in for the score.
He didn't originally want the run, but he didn't see anything in the passing game, so he scrambled, and wouldn't you know it, he scores a touchdown anyway. It's awfully nice to have a quarterback who can make things happen with his legs.
Cano now to add the extra point. So he missed his first two, but this time it's good.
Finally.
Extend the lead. Just a four-play drive that time. And Cam able to take it himself in for the score.
Dude.
Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. Goes out of bounds, and that's obviously why the flag comes out here.
And now you can see the defense greeting the kicker as they go out to play. The starting field position for the offense is excellent. Puts a lot more pressure on the defensive guys.
Yeah, and if the kicker thinks he's really lonesome after a play like this.
Hey, you better hope that he's lonesome, because who's ever standing next to him is probably on the defensive side, and they're none too happy.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down.
See, at that play, and understand just how tough it is to cover tight ends, especially the ones running on the NFL nowadays. I'm glad I didn't make it in that way. I would have a really difficult time.
But then you get to sit up here a minute.
Yeah, that's fun, isn't it? They have a really nice game right there on first down for them. Brings up a nice second down for them.
They're going to hurry back to the line now. From midfield here, Dalton. And a right side completion here by LaFell. That throw good for four. It's second down. Another chance for Dalton. Points the target and he hands it over the middle. And he'll be brought down. It looks like right at the 40. It'll go as a gain of six that time, and it moves the chains as well. Dalton, first and 10. To the sideline. Oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs. In this case, the feet did a little toe tap to stay inbounds.
Now, hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. It's just their first, so they'll have two remaining here before we get to halftime.
Whenever I see a drop like that, I have to kind of take a step back and check myself a little bit. So used to seeing those big guys make big-time spectacular plays that when they drop one, I have to remind myself, we ask a lot out of these guys. Block and catch the football, not easily done in today's NFL.
And this won't get there. Won't be online either. It's no good. Off to the right. And that's the risk of the long field goal miss here at this stage of the second quarter. You give up great field position.
and that gives them one more opportunity to make something happen and something big. And we've seen crazy stuff happen at the end of halves.
Now they'll run it on the toss. Trying to turn the corner, but he's going to be stopped right near the line of scrimmage. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine.
A one-yard gain could look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of one-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you have to start thinking about throwing it a little bit more. But if it's just the occasional one-yard run, hey, congratulations to the defense. They won that one. Come back and get them the next time.
But he was looking for the connection with Devin Funchess. And it'll bring up third down.
Fans do love the long ball, don't they? And he already found his guy once. Tried to give him another chance there, didn't he?
Yeah, he did. Couldn't connect. But as you alluded to, he does have that touchdown from earlier, trying to keep him in the rhythm. And this is caught inside the front. So after that big play, let's see if they can catch the defense maybe on their heels. Now Newton. And we'll take it across for Panthers touchdown. Matt Dixon, as the first half is winding down, and the Panthers have got it on cruise control.
Now the coach talked about those late-in-the-half scores, especially ones that give your team a pretty decent cushion. He said those could be the ones that could finish off a squad if you let them.
Yeah, they've got the cushion. This half has been theirs. Gano now following the touchdown here to kick it away. That's fielded in the end zone. And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25.
Yeah! Oh. Oh, man.
Oh. So as they take it over, we step aside. And Suckup will put this one right through. So these two teams will head back to their respective locker rooms here in Super Bowl 52 from Minnesota. As we send you down to our EA Sports Studios in Orlando, where we find our man Larry Ridley with our halftime report.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. The Bengals have to be very disappointed right now. The Panthers are dominating the scoreboard here at the Super Bowl, and they really just need to avoid big mistakes moving forward. All right, let's get it going. Here's the first half highlights. Now, first and 10. Here the defense will come up with a pick. Tolman's reading the play and comes away with it in the run. Offense on the field now after the INT. In double coverage, Newton finds Benjamin, and he's caught for the touchdown. Panthers go up by 6. Funchess is wide open here on the catch, and this long run goes for a touchdown. Panthers up now by 21. Third down from the 46. Quick pass and completion is made here, and he'll be tackled at their own 9-yard line. Continuing on the drive, Newton's going to take it off the right side, and he'll go in for a score as the blowout is on. We go late into the second. Dixon's the target here, and this play will go for 6. The lead continues to mount. Still a little time left on the clock. Bernard's got great blocking here. He'll pick up more than 40 yards on the play. That'll do it from our EA Sports Studios. The second half of Super Bowl 52 still to come. As we kick it back over to Brandon and Charles in Minneapolis.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number 3. This is feeling at the goal line. And nice work on the return as they'll start their drive
Just back, what are the 30-yard line.
Out come the Panthers. They'll have it first on offense in the third quarter. They built a good first half lead. Now they have a chance to add on to it.
And what I'm thinking is that the offensive staff spent the entire halftime just working with them on, here's what we think they're going to do to attack us in the second half. Nice first half that we've had, guys, but be prepared for some change-ups. We're going to see them when we kick it off in the second half.
See how they handle any adjustments that might be made defensively. Looking to jam the receivers at the line here. Press coverage, look defensively. Again, we'll see the pistol here. Now a first down throw for Newton. Shields is set. Here. It's a gain of seven, and it's a second down. Second down now after the pass completion. The throw on second down is Newton. It's complete right side to Benjamin. And he'll be brought down. It looks like right at the 40.
We talk about mobility on quarterbacks all the time. Here's what really pays off. Able to move, evade, and his accurate throwing on the run and picking up a first down.
On first down, Newton. And a scary incompletion, almost picked off. It would have been their first INT of the game. Instead, second down.
Well, he did almost everything right. Excellent coverage, breaks on the football, just unable to haul it in and take it the other way. So he dropped an interception. The key for him now, don't dwell on it. Just move on to the next play.
On play action, Newton. His back foot, he'll heave this one deep, and he almost intercepted it. They haven't picked the ball off yet. That probably should have been their first, and it's third down now. Incomplete pass on second down. Let's see what the offense draws up here on third. The toss play, Stewart, and some room to work.
Got it.
A very nice juke gets him a first down yardage there.
That's the desired outcome coming out here in the second half, of being able to run the football and establish a little bit of pace and maybe even a bit of dominance in the line of scrimmage. One more time to continue. Way too early to think about this being ball control time. But the way they're running it, you got to think. They may want to continue that and see if they can go ahead and grind their opponents into submission. Yeah, let me pump out my chest a little bit. Even if I'm not rooting for either team, that was a really nice defensive play. It's awfully fun to watch, even in an offensive game.
The only option left. Now that play is blown up, losing yardage back at the 35. So he loses 40 yards there. Now third down.
And on this play, the read for the quarterback was the defensive end, and he was totally focused on the quarterback. He should have given it off inside to the running back. Instead, he kept it and ended up taking a loss on the play.
Back to throw, Newton. He's going to air one out. And that's going to be caught by Funches for a Carolina touchdown. Devin Funches, his second touchdown this Super Bowl. And the Panthers just continue to pour it on.
In order to lead in the game, you're going to get plenty of contributors, but that's his second touchdown catch of this game. He's one of the key guys in this one.
And you better believe he'll be looking for the hat trick here as this one continues to go. Goodell now following the touchdown here to kick it away. That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. So here are the Bengals now as they get their first possession of this second half. They're down in this game. A chance for the offense, though, to put something on the board, get some momentum here in half two.
Gotta get things kick-started for them. And you know, at the half, they discussed how they were going to get that done. This is where scripting comes into play.
How many plays do you script on it?
Most of the time in the first half, you're scripting 12 to 16. I think in the second half, you're really scripting more like 8 to 10. Kind of a starter or an opener, whatever terminology they use. Just something to get you up to a quick start.
Dalton gives to Bernard. And he'll take this up near the 35, maybe the 34. 9 yards on the pickup there as he'll be left with third and one.
And once again, leverage wins. The offensive line, lower than the defensive front. They moved them and found some good space for the guy carrying the ball. The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
Wow. Fortunately, he was able to get it back, but it's left his guys in a bit of a hole here. They're backed up deep to start this drive.
I know there's no magnet in the ball, but sometimes for the punt returner, after such a scramble, it sort of feels that way, doesn't it? He has it, he loses it, somehow the ball finds its way back to him.
The tone for his sitting, you know, he's taking a deep sigh of relief right now. Sure. And they went big on first down, proves unfruitful.
I guess they figure with a guy who is that hot downfield, who knows how to get the ball into the end zone, you throw it up and give him every opportunity, even though that one fell incomplete.
Yeah, he's already been in the end zone multiple times, trying to target him again deep there, but unsuccessful. Flushed out right. And the tight end, Olsen, right side. And they'll bring him down here up at about the 22-yard line. It'll be a pickup of 10 yards. And that'll bring up what looks to be a third of inches. Can't be more than a half a foot.
And there's a completion to the tight end. And look at the size of these players nowadays. That spot, 6'4", 6'5", and up. A lot of guys used to be basketball players. Somehow came back to football. That's really good for the game of football. You get better athleticism, great hand-eye coordination. Guys who know how to control their bodies when they run their routes. Third down is a down. Both sides know they absolutely have to win. And the name of the game for the defense is pressure on the quarterback. But pressure on the quarterback with contact, that's how you end up winning it.
Fielded just inside the 30. A good return there, call it 13 yards. And the Bengals take possession. Starts with a handoff to Bernard. Yeah, able to work about 5 yards out of this as he's taken down up near the 47. Back now here on EA Sports. And this is a blowout so far as we get set for the fourth quarter. A very one-sided affair. Dalton throwing on second down. Receiver complete. A nice pick up there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks. Really nice little connection there. They go with the corner route, and it works out well.
And the best way to set up the corner route is to throw slants throughout the ball game, so when you're able to get back outside, the defender has to respect the inside game.
Underneath, this is Bernard. No gain, and it's second down. So second and 10 here. They come out five wide, three of them to the right side. It's second down, Dalton looking. That was hit, and Dalton lost the football.
On plays like this, when the ball comes free, it's often unusual for the team that lost it to get it back, because this is a quarterback. The ball gets away from him. Everyone else is trying to execute what they're supposed to do on offense. They're usually looking in the other direction, downfield, or moved away from it. In this case, though, a teammate is able to come up with the ball.
Here's Kevin Huber now, as he'll come on for his fifth kick of the night. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And problem spreading to the punt team now. This one goes all the way into the end zone on the fly, so that'll come back to the 20. Carolina getting set to take the field. And on the last go around, they really couldn't get anything going.
Play the punt from deep inside their own territory, which means you're going to lose the field position battle as a general rule. What they're looking for now is a little more consistency. Move the ball at least a few times on offense, get a couple of first downs, and hopefully flip the field.
Yeah, just something to build off of. That's what they're looking for here. So an instance there of Cam being Cam. We know he can use his legs.
And with that big body, it's hard to get him down, even if you get a clip.
And no escaping this time as he'll go down. Challenged the play, it did not pay off.
And that means he lost a timeout in that challenge.
And as a coach, you hate that. Don't know if you took the advice of the player, you threw it yourself, but it didn't go your way.
At the end of the day, it all comes back to the head coach. He has the final.
There he goes, right side. 20. Touchdown, Carolina. A great play there. His second touchdown of the Super Bowl. And the Panthers have got it on cruise control. And my friend, I think it's safe to say that this game is pretty much deceased at this point. It's taken a knee, so to speak.
It is definitely this victory formation. Take the snap, take the knee, call it a night, you know, call it a game, call it whatever. I agree with you, Tony. I don't think there's much left to get except for those who want to run up the score.
I knew this was over about a minute ago when you took your stat sheet and just flipped it over your shoulder in a trash can.
Yeah, that's similar to the guys cutting tape off right before the game's over. We know this thing's done.
That'll be taken in the end zone. And no run back here. This will be a touchback, and it comes out to the 25-yard line. The Panthers defense gearing up as they take the field. They'll be hoping to come up with that same type of effort they had last time when they forced the punt that led to a touchdown.
And that type of effort just continues to carry over. Because once you get it done once, you feel like you can do it again and again. It's no guarantee, but you got to like the confidence that they take back out into the field.
Now, will they keep that confidence? Time to find out. Completed pass play. Now let's see if they go back to the air or to the ground. Second down. Incomplete. And ready for third and six.
We say it. I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass trick in pregame warm-up, but I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation.
380. 380. On first and 10, here's Andy Dalton. Down man over the middle, it's Woods. A gain of six there on first.
One thing I can say pretty safely, that route is not called if you don't have a guy who can throw the ball and put some mustard on it. Because if you're going to lollipop it in the middle of the field, bad things usually happen. It takes a strong-armed guy who can rifle it in there, and they were able to successfully complete that one.
2 minutes to go here in Super Bowl 52 from Minneapolis. We're back to crown a champion after this. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. This will be Dalton again. Be brought down just shy of midfield at the 49-yard line.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
First and 10. To the right sideline, but it's incomplete. Tyler Boyd, the former Pitt Panther, was the target, and that'll bring up second down.
How about I'll sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it, or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it, no one got it. And Green with a catch left side. And they'll get nine there as that sets him up better for third down. And there, the man coverage not good enough, partner, and they're able to complete the pass.
Excellent recognition of the man coverage. And a